Now, next problem is, if cos alpha plus 2 cos beta plus 3 cos gamma is equal to sin alpha plus 2 sin beta plus 3 sin gamma is equal to 0, then prove that sin of 3 alpha plus 8 times sin of 3 beta plus 27 times sin of 3 gamma is equal to 18 sin alpha plus beta plus gamma. Now here, two results are already given. The first one is cos alpha plus 2 cos beta plus 3 cos gamma is 0. And the other is sin alpha plus 2 sin beta plus 3 sin gamma is 0. Now if you'll observe over here, then the coefficient of cos gamma and sin gamma is same, that is 3. Similarly, coefficient of cos beta and sin beta is same. And coefficient of cos alpha and sin alpha is same. So, in such type of problems, we always consider a complex number where we take all cos terms in real part and all sin terms in the imaginary part. So, let's proceed like that. So, here we'll consider cos alpha plus 2 cos beta plus 3 cos gamma in real part and sin alpha 2 sin beta 3 sin gamma in imaginary part. So, all cos terms in real part and all sin terms in imaginary part, because according to polar form, cos is generally a real part and sin is imaginary part. Now next term is, we will group the terms together according to the coefficients. So here cos alpha plus I sin alpha will come together. Next 2 cos beta and 2 sin beta will come together. So it will become cos alpha plus I sin alpha plus, from here we can take 2 outside, in bracket we will get cos beta plus I sin beta, and in the last step we will get 3 into cos gamma plus I sin gamma is equal to 0. Now here we can see that cos alpha plus I sin alpha, it means we are getting a complex number in polar form. So here we are getting one more complex number and here we are getting one more complex number. So let's assume that the first complex number as x, that is cos alpha plus I sin alpha. Second complex number as y, that is 2 times cos beta plus I sin beta. And third complex number as z, 3 cos gamma plus I sin gamma. So, as we are assuming first number as x, second as y and third as z, we will get this result as x plus y plus z equal to 0. I will say this is result number 1. Now, let's come to the proof part. So, here we want sin 3 alpha plus 8 times sin 3 beta plus 27 times sin 3 gamma equal to this. Now, here you can see that angle alpha has become 3 alpha, angle beta has become 3 beta and angle gamma has become 3 gamma. It means we need to make this angle. Now angle is nothing but argument. So it means we need to make this argument as 3 times of current argument. So if we want to make it 3 times, then we need to apply de Moivre over here. It means if I will consider cube of all these complex numbers, so due to cube, we will get cos of 3 beta plus I sin 3 beta. Similarly here, cos of 3 gamma plus I sin 3 gamma, and here cos of 3 alpha plus I sin 3 alpha. It means if we will consider cube of this complex number, then we might get the left hand side of the question. So let's take cube of the complex number. So we know one formula, that is x plus y plus z the whole cube. So, we have learned this formula in the 12th standard. So according to it, x plus y plus z, the whole cube is x cube plus y cube plus z cube plus 3 times x plus y plus z into xy plus yz plus zx minus 3xyz. Now, according to this condition, that is condition number 1, x plus y plus z is 0, hence this term becomes 0 and this term becomes 0. So, we will get 0 equal to x cube plus y cube plus z cube, it is 0 minus 3xyz. So, therefore, x cube plus y cube plus z cube, this minus 3xyz will go on the other side, so it will become positive. So, we will get it is equal to 3xyz. Now, let's substitute values of x, y and z. So, when we will substitute value of x over here and when we will find out the cube, we will automatically get 3 alpha at cos and sin because of de Moivre. So, let's substitute. So, therefore, we will get cos of alpha plus I sin alpha the whole cube plus y is 2 times cos of beta plus I sin beta whole cube plus z is 3 times cos of gamma plus I sin gamma the whole cube is equal to 3 times x into y into z. So, we will multiply these 3 terms. We will get cos alpha plus I sin alpha. Second is 2 times cos beta plus I sin beta. And third is 3 times cos of gamma plus I sin gamma. Now, on left hand side, we can find out cube of the complex numbers using de Moivre's theorem, and similarly we can multiply these 3 complex numbers on right hand side. So, on left hand side we will get cos 3 alpha plus I sin 3 alpha 2 cube, that is 8, cos 3 beta plus I sin 3 beta and so on. So, I will write it down on next slide. So, this will become therefore cos of 3 alpha plus I sin 3 alpha plus 8 times cos of 3 beta plus I sin 3 beta plus 27 times cos of 3 gamma plus I sin 3 gamma is equal to, if we will multiply on left hand side, if we will multiply on right hand side, we will get 3 into 2 into 3, that is 6 into 3, 18. Next, we want to multiply the 3 complex numbers in polar form. So, we know whenever we multiply any 2 complex numbers in polar form, that times their arguments get added. So, here arguments are alpha, beta and gamma. It will get added. So, we will get 18 times cos of alpha plus beta plus gamma plus I sin alpha plus beta plus gamma. Next, we will take all real terms on left hand side together and all imaginary terms together. So, cos 3 alpha plus 8 times cos 3 beta plus 27 times cos 3 gamma plus I imaginary terms sin 3 alpha. Here the imaginary term is 8 times sin 3 beta and here the imaginary term is 27 times sin 3 gamma is equal to, we will get 18 times cos of alpha plus beta plus gamma plus I 18 times sin of alpha plus beta plus gamma. Now, let's see the question once again. So, in the question, we have been asked this result, that is to prove sin 3 alpha plus 8 times sin 3 beta plus 27 times sin 3 gamma. So you can see here that sin is the imaginary part of our deduction. So what we will do is, we will compare imaginary parts on both sides. So on the left hand side we will get this term, and on the right hand side we will get 18 times sin alpha plus beta plus gamma, and it is our required result. So I'll write it down. After writing, comparing imaginary parts on both sides, we will get sin of 3 alpha plus 8 times sin of 3 beta plus 27 times sin of 3 gamma is equal to 18 times sin of alpha plus beta plus gamma, and this is the required answer.